do not swear at all, neither by heaven, for it is God's throne, nor by the earth, for it is his footstool, nor by Jerusalem, for it is the city of the great king. Nor shall you swear by your head, because you cannot make one hair white or black, except that the white man have discovered the bleach now. So we have to update the Bible. But let your yes be yes, and let your no be no, for whatever is more than this is from the evil world. Amen. Glory. Verse 38, you have heard that it was said, an eye for an eye, and a tooth for a tooth. But I tell you, not to resist an evil person, but whoever slaps you on your right cheek, turn the other to him also. If anyone wants to sue you and take away your tunic, let him have your cloak also. And whoever compels you to go 1 mile, go with him too. Give to him who asks you, and from him who wants to borrow from you, do not turn away. Now, the Lord is not teaching us here to be foolish or stupid and leave ourselves defenseless against armed robbers, terrorists, or murderers. The basic moral principle here is to exercise maximum restraint and tolerance, slow to anger, and readiness to forgive.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
In 43, he said, you have heard that it was said, you shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I say to you, love your enemies, bless those who curse you, do well to those who hate you, and pray for those who spitefully use you and persecute you. In the whole of the Ten Commandments, you could see that he did not come to destroy the Ten Commandments, as he said in Matthew 5:17-20. Think not that I have come to destroy the law or the prophets. I have not come to destroy, but to fulfill. For verily I say unto you, the heaven and earth pass, one jot or one little shall in no wise pass from the law, till all be fulfilled.
Amen.
Whosoever therefore shall break one of these least commandments, and shall teach men so, he shall be called the least in the kingdom of heaven. Mm-hmm. But whosoever shall do and teach them, the same shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven. But I say to you, that except your righteousness shall exceed the righteousness of the scribes and the Pharisees, ye shall in no case enter into the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, this golden message clearly shows us the authority and the divinity of Jesus, thereby equating himself with the law of God as the authoritative standard of righteousness. In fact, Jesus said that he came to fulfill the law and the prophets. Jesus as the incarnate word of God, as we read also in John 1:1, is the source of all truth. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. I am the life. I am the life. Jesus had just been telling his disciples about his impending death, and now he was claiming to be the source of all life. In John 10:17-18, Jesus declared that he was going to lay down his life for his sheep and then take it back again. He spoke of his authority over life and death as being granted to him by the Father. In John 14:19, he gave the promise that because I live, you also will live.
Amen.
Amen.
So the deliverance he was about to provide was not a political or social deliverance, which most of the Jews were seeking, but a true deliverance from a life of bondage to sin and death to a life of freedom in eternity. Amen. So in these words, Jesus was declaring himself the great I am, the only path to heaven, the only true measure of righteousness, and the source of both physical and spiritual life.
Amen.
He was staking his claim as the very God of creation, the Lord who blessed Abraham, and the Holy One who inhabits eternity.
Amen.
He did this so the disciples will be able to face the dark days ahead and carry on the mission of declaring the gospel to the world.
Amen.
Of course, we know from Scripture that they still didn't understand, and it took several visits from their risen Lord to shake them out of their disbelief. But once they understood the truth of his words, they became changed people, and the world has never been the same again. So how do we follow him today? The same way, of course, the disciples did long time ago. They heard the word of Jesus and believed them. They took his word and obeyed them. They confessed their sins to Jesus as their Lord and God. They believed that he died to take the punishment of their sins and rose from the dead to give them new life. They followed his examples and command to tell others the truth about sin, righteousness, and judgment. Where we follow him in the way, we can be assured of following him all the way to heaven. Do not let us be hearers alone, as definitely for now we are. But let us strive from today to be doers of his commandments. Amen. Through obedience. Our God lays so much emphasis on obedience. As we can read from the Bible, one, God rewards obedience. As we also read in Genesis 22:15, and the angel of the Lord called on Abraham out of heaven the second time and said, by myself have I sworn, said the Lord, for because thou hast done this thing, and hast not withheld thy son, thy only son, that in blessing I will bless thee, and in multiplying I will multiply thy seed as the stars of the heaven, and as the sand which is upon the sea shore, and thy seed shall possess the gate of his enemies, and in thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because thou hast obeyed my voice. What did Abraham do? He obeyed God without complaining. Amen. Two, in Exodus 19:1-5, and Moses went up unto God, and Jehovah called unto him out of the mountain, saying, thus shalt thou say to the house of Jacob, and tell the children of Israel, ye have seen what I did unto the Egyptians, and how I bear you on eagle's wings, and brought you unto myself. Now therefore, if ye will obey my voice indeed, and keep my covenant, then ye shall be my possession from among all people, for all the earth is mine. And also in Luke 11:28, Jesus replied, but even more blessed are all who hear the word of God and put it into practice. And in James 1:22-25, he said, but don't just listen to God's word. You must do what it says. Otherwise, you are only fooling yourself. For if you listen to the word and don't obey, it's like glancing at your face in a mirror. You see yourself, you walk away and forget what you look like. But if you look carefully into the perfect law that sets you free, and if you do what it says, and don't forget what you heard, then God will bless you for doing it. Amen.
Amen.
And obedience to God proves our love for God. As we also read in 1 John 5:1-5, whoever believed that Jesus is the Christ is born of God. And everyone that loveth him, that begot, loveth him also that is begotten of him. By this we know that we love the children of God, when we love God and keep his commandment. For this is the love of God, that we keep his commandment, and his commandment are not grievous. For whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. Who is he that overcometh the world? But he that believeth that Jesus is the Son of God.
Amen.
Amen. And then 2 John 1:6, and this is love, that we walk according to his commandment. This is the commandment, just as you have heard from the beginning, so you should walk in it.
Amen.
Obedience to God demonstrates our faith. Amen. If we don't obey, if we are disobedient, then we don't have any faith at all. And that's what 1 John is saying, 3-6, and we can be assured that we know him if we obey his commandment. If someone claims, I know God, but doesn't obey God's commandment, that person is a liar and is not living in the truth